Number 7. Attack in Telangana. In February of 2019, a rather unusual cobra incident was reported in the Indian state of Telangana. A cyclist and his passenger were going down the road when a cobra lunged at them. Both men promptly abandoned the bicycle as the serpent had gotten caught in the wheel. Fortunately, they weren't hurt as the snake struggled to free itself. The outcome could have been much worse considering that the Indian cobra, also known as the spectacled cobra, is responsible for a significant number of snake bite fatalities throughout India. Cobras are arguably the most iconic snakes on the planet. There are, however, numerous snakes that have the cobra moniker attached to them. Depending on how the term is defined, species range from 25 to over 250, and the vast majority of them are in the Elapidae family. These are snakes characterized by hollow fangs, located at the front of the mouth, through which they inject venom into their prey. Elapids in the Naja genus are the ones most frequently referred to as true cobras. The notorious king cobra, the longest venomous snake on the planet, is in a class of its own as the sole species in the Ophiophagus genus. Members of the Naja genus are slender-bodied serpents, the largest of which grow to be about 10 feet long. These creatures are known for their threatening upright stance, intimidating hood display, and lethal venom. The distinctive hood is formed as the snake spreads out its neck ribs to deter predators. Some species in the genus, commonly known as spitting cobras, have the ability to squirt venom out of their mouths as a defensive mechanism. Cobras are exceptionally dangerous snakes, as all species possess a bite that can kill human beings. Number 6. Moxie and Miley. In July of 2019, two heroic dachshund dogs fought off a cobra in the Philippines. The serpent, which is among the most venomous cobra species, was found outside a family home in Kinapawan City. It was slithering towards a room where a one-year-old baby was sleeping. Moxie, a two-year-old dachshund, approached the cobra and started pawing at it. The other pet, Miley, aged 4, charged the reptile and picked it up in her jaws. The snake then tried to escape by rushing to the front door of the house. The guard dogs worked together to drag the reptile into the road. After a fight which had lasted several minutes, the cobra stopped moving. Unfortunately, Miley had been repeatedly bitten by the cobra and soon succumbed to her injuries as well. Moxie survived, but was left blind after being sprayed in the eyes with venom. Number 5. Sabron Kamarudin. In 2012, while working at the Toronto Mini Zoo in Malaysia, Sabron Kamarudin was bitten by a king cobra. The 25-year-old man was cleaning a serpent's cage when it lunged at him and plunged its fangs into his left wrist. Kamarudin was taken to a hospital where he had to wait for over 4 hours until antivenom was delivered from Kuala Lumpur. During this time, the cobra's venom spread through his arm. Doctors warned that Kamarudin would eventually need to have his hand amputated, but he refused to heed their warnings, believing that treatment would suffice. A few years later, however, the man was told he'd developed Pseudomonas aeruginosa, a bacterial infection in the bone. In 2019, he started experiencing severe pain in his elbow, and his hand had become horribly swollen. The father of two was at risk of the infection damaging his heart. In January of 2020, Kamarudin made the difficult decision of having his left arm amputated. His limb was surgically removed at the elbow, 8 years after he'd been bitten by the king cobra. Cobras have featured prominently in human mythology since antiquity. Wajet was one of ancient Egypt's oldest goddesses. Depicted as a woman with the head of an Egyptian cobra, she was regarded as the protector of the country and its pharaoh. The current distribution of cobras ranges from Indonesia, Southeast Asia, and India to the Middle East and throughout Africa. In each of these regions, cobras feature prominently among the most dangerous snake species. The Indian cobra is part of the Indian subcontinent's Big Four, along with the common crate, Russell's viper, and the Indian saw-scaled viper. Together, they are responsible for the greatest number of human snake bites on the subcontinent. The Arabian cobra is a major cause of death in the Arabian Peninsula. The black cobra native to Africa is the largest of all true cobra species, while the Caspian cobra, native to Central Asia, is the most venomous. Other deadly snakes of the Naja genus include the Chinese cobra, the Philippine cobra, and the equatorial spitting cobra. Number 4, Lucian Naido. While working as a response officer for a South African security company, 23-year-old Lucian Naido was called to a home in Verulam for the removal of a cobra. A couple had spotted the serpent as it was trying to get in through a window in the bedroom where the toddler was sleeping. Naido and a colleague were dispatched to the address. Both men had been trained in snake handling. As Naido approached the cobra, it squirted venom at his face. Even though he was wearing sunglasses, the venom got into his eyes, causing a painful burning sensation. Naido's colleague called for backup, and the cobra was eventually shot and killed. The security officer suffered from blurred vision and was taken to a hospital. Luckily, he was treated and discharged with no permanent damage to his eyes. Cobras have an excellent sense of smell and well-developed night vision. Some species, such as the Caspian cobra, have a reputation for being aggressive. Also known as the Russian cobra, this is the most venomous of all Naja species. Its venom owns potent neurotoxins, but also cytotoxins, which attack the human body on a cellular level. Untreated bites have a mortality rate of up to 80%. The bite of many snakes in the Naja genus is fatal due to the neurotoxic components of its venom. It affects the nerves and paralyzes muscles, leading to death by respiratory failure or cardiac arrest. The venom of the Philippine cobra, for example, is purely neurotoxic, with minimal pain and tissue damage at the site of the bite. Cases of envenomation have resulted in death in as little as 30 minutes. Since the venom of some Naja species is so toxic, fatalities can be quite common in both treated and untreated victims. The venom of a spitting cobra acts as a powerful irritant on the victim's skin. If it enters the eyes and isn't cleared out immediately, it can cause temporary or even permanent blindness. Number 3, Norjani. An Indonesian snake charmer identified only as Norjani was killed by a king cobra he was showing off to his neighbors. He'd caught the reptile about a week prior and was keeping it in his wooden hut for use in traditional medicine. The bizarre performance that Norjani put on involved him taunting and teasing the reptile, which was spun around and hit. As it grew increasingly angrier, the cobra lashed out at the charmer and bit him on the arm. Nevertheless, he continued with the routine. The snake then bit him in the face, but Norjani just smiled and kept performing. A few hours later, however, he started feeling sick. He was taken to a hospital, but by then, the snake's powerful venom had wrought havoc on his body. Norjani was pronounced dead. His family subsequently chopped the cobra's head off, which they believed would avenge Norjani's death and keep the evil spirits at bay. Today's topic was requested by Brandon Seepersword. If you have any other topics you'd like to learn about, subscribe and let us know in the comments section below. Number 2, Prapawi Prawat. In the Thai province of Surat Thani, a 9-year-old girl sustained a fatal cobra bite while she was sleeping. Following her parents' divorce, Prapawi Prawat had been living with her two grandmothers. When one of the elderly women tried to wake her up for school, she found that the child was unresponsive. The authorities were called, and they noticed a bite mark on Prapawi's index finger. Then a large cobra was found coiled under a folded blanket next to the bed. Rescue workers reacted quickly and killed the reptile. They concluded that Prapawi had been bitten at least 8 hours before the snake was found. Avoiding a cobra attack depends on the species itself, as well as on the geographical region where it's found. First aid treatment of a bite, however, is generally the same. Make sure that the snake is gone or properly contained so that there's no risk of an additional attack. A cobra bite should be treated as a medical emergency, and getting to a hospital is a priority. Don't attempt to cut or suck out the venom. Try to stay calm and limit your movement to the necessary first aid procedures. Start at the bite site and work upwards, wrapping bandages around the affected limb. The bandages should be as tight as they'd be if you were treating a sprained ankle. Try to keep the affected limb at a level that's lower than the heart, and if available, use a rigid item as a splint. Do not remove the bandages or splint until you've reached the hospital, where you'll be treated with antivenom. Number 1, Yutapong Chaibodi. During an animal show in Phuket, Thailand, a snake handler was left battling for his life after being bitten by a king cobra. At some point during the performance, visitors watched in horror as the snake sank its teeth into Yutapong Chaibodi's arm. The 35-year-old yanked the reptile from his limb and threw it on the ground. It's likely that during the struggle, the cobra had delivered close to a full envenomation. Moments later, Chaibodi passed out and was rushed to a hospital. He was given antibodies but had to be placed on life support after he'd stopped breathing. Following several days spent in the hospital, Chaibodi recovered and was discharged, but the attack had left a mark. Even though he'd sustained a single bite, there was a number of burn-like wounds present on his arms, legs, and even on the inside of his lips. Thanks for watching. Would you rather get bitten by a Caspian cobra or have no human contact for a year? Let us know in the comments section below.